for a new game. This one is called Gone Home. This one is kind of like Dear Esther, where, you know, you walk around, you explore, stuff like that, except this one is more interactive, whereas Dear Esther is you just walk into a certain spot and the narrative picked up. This one you actually have to search for stuff. In this game you play as a young woman named Kate who comes home from a year abroad only to find out her home is completely abandoned, and she wanders around looking for her family and trying to figure out what's happened in the past year since she's been gone. So with that being said, why don't we all just settle down, grab our nice cups of water, gotta stay hydrated, and we'll start the game. New game. How you guys doing? Beating the heat? Not letting summer keep you down? It's good to know. Yep. Loading, loading, loading. Are you done yet? My god, this is an awful loading screen. Here we go.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Yep. No need to come pick me up. June 7th, 1995, 1:15 a.m. Yeah, it sounds bad out there. Oh, coming down like cats and dogs. I think I see a few cats and dogs. Well, that's a jumbled mess. Have the Christmas duck. Take that duck. There. Check the contents of my backpack. Oh, there's my passport. Boarding pass and the key. Alright. I think we're gonna have some fun with this. Oops, we're in Portland, Oregon. Yet another game that takes place in the Pacific Northwest. Anyone who's been paying attention to the games I've been doing, we did the Life is Strange series. And all those took place in the in Oregon. Is it Oregon? Yeah, Oregon. I sometimes get be there to see you, but it's impossible. Please, please don't go digging around trying to find out where I am. I don't want anyone, except my dad, to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I will be safe. And now I'm kind of worried. Hello? Let's shut the door. Nothing? Alright. Read the note. Let's see. Directions for to work from home. No, that's nothing important. Nothing good in here? This whole game is going to be nothing but invasion of privacy, which you guys know I'm all about. Folder. Read invoice. Jesus. Alright. Wait, almost $3,000 just to move.
Dear Katie, so much has changed, even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm in a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal, just like I was talking to you.
Oh, that's nice. So that's got to be Katie's younger sister, Sam. Oh, I gotta pee so bad. No, can't use the toilet. Flush it. Oh. Glorious sound. It's Author Magazine. Get published. The Secret. Alright. On this side. Cleaning powder. This is too bad. Light. Wash those hands. Alright, every room I explore, I'm leaving the door open, so I know I've been there. Goodfellow High School. Janice Greenbrier. Oh, that must be Mom. Grab board game. Over the Alps, a novel telling game. Alright. Well, I think I've sufficiently explored this closet. Where to next? We're not going upstairs just yet. I want to explore the downstairs. Yep, it's a marker. Read item. Katie's departure. Oh my goodness, she's been everywhere. Oh, she went to Amsterdam. Probably smoking weed. Not that there's anything wrong with that, I fully support it. Sam, Daniel from the old neighborhood called. He wants to come see the new house. Call him back. Mom, Daniel's a total weirdo. The only reason I ever hung out with him in the first place is he had a Nintendo when we were little. Well, that's a valid reason. Screw that guy.
Sam. Sam. Hello? Sam!
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
All right, that was kind of disturbing. Empty. Empty. What's this? Sam, Katie, Mom, and Dad. Well, that's a handsome looking family. Can I run? Oops. I can't run. Alright, let's check out what's over here. Close the door. Nothing good in there. Read letter. Oh my goodness. It's good to hear from you again. All this new house business sounds like quite the adventure. Remember the little dorm room we shared freshman year? When we were miserable fantasizing about our own dream homes. I always said I wanted a mansion. You said you just wanted a house in the woods. Look who got both. Somebody up there likes you. I could use some of that magic. Send me some lotto numbers. I'll play them. Seriously. But I shouldn't be complaining about this good old split level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. We just got new vinyl siding. Jealous yet? Yes, maybe. Let me know if you ever want to trade places. So how are the girls doing? Has Katie left on her big European adventure yet? Jealous. Sue, I miss you. Okay, so I'm guessing this is Mom's old college roommate. Who's having a hard time letting the past go. Sounds about right. Anything here to miss? Ooh. Grab the skull. Made in Mexico. Let's put that back. Trophy. Regional track and field finals. Not bad, Katie, not bad. Oops. Oh, so Katie's a bit of an athlete. Respect. That opens. Nothing there. No, I'm not turning the lamp off. I won't open the door. Alright, so I think we've sufficiently checked out this room. Let's see what's over here. Oh yeah, this isn't dark or spooky or anything. Alright, press start or Y to check your location in the house. Alright, so there's my map. We check the front porch, we check the foyer. Can we please turn on some lights? Ah, there we go. I mean, I'm not scared of the dark or anything. Hey, one of my postcards. Hi, Mom, Dad, and Sam. I'm in Paris. I have done many Parisian things, including eating la petite, I can't pronounce that, and wearing a beret. I'm going to have lots of film to develop when I get back. Sam, I'm bringing you back something from the Shakespeare Book Company since you are my favorite sister. Only sister. Love you all. Kate. Nothing. Pack of cards. Ooh, who died? Voices. What the hell? Oscar Massan, 60, of Boone County, died peacefully last month in his home. Mr. Massan was born on September 8, 1933, in the house that would be his home for the rest of his life. He attained his degree in pharmacy at a young age and returned to Boone County to practice. He quickly became a well-loved figure at the center of his community. In the decades of his passing, he was seldom seen outside his home. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, surviving nephew, Terrence Greenbrier, as well as a... Oh, so he must be related. Oh, who's this? Is that Sis? No, that says DeSoto. Yeah, I got no idea who that is. Alright, I'm seriously hearing voices and this is creeping me the hell out. I don't like it, guys. I'm gonna hide in this closet. Nice and safe. What do we got here? Welcome, new students. We hope you're using. Blah, 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 blah.
Oh. Oh my god. You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
Why are we the Psycho House Girl? Well, why are we the Psycho House? What is going on with this house? Open. Oh, that's the voice I was hearing.
County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County.
That was scaring the shit out of me. That's copyrighted. I don't need another game getting silenced because of copyrights. Terry! Hey man, how have you been? I know you're a published author and everything now, but my editor at HF Aficionado has too much review work to go around and he's looking for another freelancer. Naturally, I thought of you. You were saying in your past letter how much of a pain it's been trying to find a publisher for your latest work of literature, and writing stereo reviews is dead simple. Sit at home with a glass of scotch, listen to some records, and write up how it sounds, and then get paid. I've included some issues of the mag to use as examples. If you're interested, send some samples to my editor and tell him your old college chum might send you his address.
Wet.
Blood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Well, Mike, look at some data on that. 1978. Okay. It's that book Dad wrote. Is it any good? Accidental Savior. My history might be a little rusty, but I'm pretty sure JFK didn't survive that. Right. November 21st, 1963. John Russell knows that the president's life hangs in the balance, but who would believe him? Not just another James Bond, T. Wales, mummy. A high-class political thriller, Nicholas Wolf removed. Alright, sounds like Dad wrote a pretty good book. Wait, what am I doing? What's going on? Oh, I kneel down. We have airplane moonraker.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties:
Blade Runner Director's Cut,
Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria
County.
Lots
of X-Files.
Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows.
The Andromeda Strain.
Flood conditions are expected at
Time
lower elevations.
Time Machine. Clue and Top Gun. Ghostbusters and Labyrinth. I seriously love their movie collection. Clash of the Titans. Yo, can I borrow a movie, guys? Shut up. What's this? Sam thought this might help. Dad, making friends. Feeling lonely? It's a piece of cake for my friends. Never worry again about having friends to spend time with. Facebook will teach you to make friends even when you're shy. That sounds like a load of crap.
You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them? Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk. But sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. And she's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
Nice. Okay, so I wonder if that was the picture of the girl we saw in the hallway? Maybe, possibly. But what I want to know is, why didn't they tell me they were getting... Oh, they ate the whole damn thing. Bunch of asshats. Yep, it's a coffee mug. Yep, it's a coaster. What do we got here? 2001. Ooh, The Dark Crystal. Some seriously good movies. More X-Files. Soda plate. Alright, we'll close you since I can't see the... walk past you. What's that say? Oh, we were the nephew. Okay, well, father is the nephew. Enclosed, please find a pioneer unit with no people. Oh, this one's TV. Oh, it's empty. Forget about that. Maybe if the matches work, I grab them. There we go. TV. Someone seriously likes the X-Files. I mean, I'm not complaining. X-Files is pretty awesome. Anything? No? Nothing. A pillow fort. I like it. Grab a poltergeist book. Hauntings and poltergeist. And a truth. I'll find out the truth behind stories that are familiar. You know, I don't think I need to read that right now. That's just creepy enough without adding to my imagination. What do we got here? The Heaven at the Edge of the World, Samantha Greenbrier, Grade 2. Huh? Kinda Captain Allegra looked off at the ocean. It went on forever, or so it seemed. Someday she would find the edge to get to a paradise there. She heard a cannon fire. Boom. It was the Black Pirate Ship. She yelled, "I thought we lost them at Horse Island." The first mate said, "Blah, blah, 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 blah." I mean, you guys can read this. I don't feel like reading it. Anything else I should know about up here? No? Alright, coming out of the closet. Giggity. See what I did there? I don't like that corner. What's this? Oh. Hey, are you the new girl, Sam? I'm Tommy. I'm at the back. What? I can't read this. Hi, Tommy. Yes, I'm Samantha, and yes, I'm new. What's up? I just thought since you're new, maybe you could use a friend. I don't have a lot of friends either, and so I thought I'd ask you. No, I don't mind. What did you want to ask? Is this your uncle who went psycho? Does it run in the family? Wow. Nice conversation started there, Tommy. Jackass. Okay, this place is kind of freaking me out. Oh yeah, this is what I need. What's this? Electrical expansion. Repairing the house is typically up to safety and temperature requirements, however, multiple layers of wire have been added into the structure the last 100 years. The system is frequently unpredictable, lights blink out for no clear reason, pressure on floorboards and door frames disrupts circuits, wire directly on the surface, properly reworked metal is going to be highly destructive to the walls. Alright, well, Dad feels like not addressing them, so whatever. Hopefully you won't die in a horrible house fire. Nothing? Anything? No? Can't read those. Nothing. Grab 3 ring binder. Can I open it? No? Okay. Screw you, 3 binder. Nothing. Yep, it's a highlighter. What's this? This will laser disc compound. They say that a jack of all trades is a master of none. I have to disagree. Mastery is not a question of specialization. The sureness of purpose and dedication to craft. You happen to be in the market for a combination LD CD player, you'll be glad to know that Pioneer seems to share this particular. Alright. What's going on here? You can do better. See, back to basics, sent back in time to Dallas again. What if JFK wasn't JFK? Mind blower. JFK president, US plus USSR coalition. Paradox results in JFK death being desired outcome. Magic bullet. Sounds like Dad's really stretching on his next book. Why not disrupt the motorcade minutes before? Or Lee Harvey Oswald fire. I don't know, Dad, why not? John Russell opened his eyes and saw the stars twinkling as if they were lying. This is a head swim. Really did. The breach of a starship Archimedes. Jesus Christ, Dad, you're really jumping the shark here. Enter combination. I don't know, no sticky. Is there anything in here that would give me a combination? 1963? Better been rain on the roof. Something on here? I don't see why. Oh wow, a library. That's pretty nice. Screw you, Lid. That second one. What is that? The Accidental Pariah. Message from our future, save the president's life. For hours. James Bond for today's audience, Casey DeWitt. Oh, fucking hell. Compelling, a thriller worth its salt, David Pittman, faster. Now, what I want to know is why is there a naked chicken out here? Oh, gosh, Dad. Ooh, the women of wrestling. Dad's a perv. Oh, that's hilarious. What's something over here? Fresh true stories. I was a teenage drag queen. Good to know. Stranger Under My Roof, the number one bestseller of teams. Yeah, I don't think so. Open folder. Ooh. 0451. Someone write that down. Dear Terrence, David asked me to write you regarding the reviews you've been submitting the last few months. Frankly, becoming more trouble than they're worth from an editing standpoint. There's a word limit. It's your job to stay under it, not mine to cut back to it. Even then, it's becoming harder and harder to weed out the tangents and non sequiturs from the usable copy without heavy rewrites. The readers at home theater aficionado want to hear about the quality value of the hardware, not ruminations on your childhood. Jesus Christ, Dad. If it were up to me, I wouldn't be writing this letter. I'd just be cutting you loose. There's tons of guys half your age who would take half the rate to write stuff I could actually use. But David's known you for a long time, and he's the boss. So I'm giving you one more shot on this say-so. You should write him a nice note thanking him for his patience and generosity. Look through your old stuff and start submitting reviews like that again. Then everybody will be happy. Brent. You, Brent. I'm a best-selling author, okay? You can't talk to me like that. 0451. You guys wrote that down, right? Sweet. Zero. 4-5-1.
Yeah.
Just call me Master. Dear Mr. Masson, please find and close your original document and a typed copy of your records, a notarized copy of your right. I ask for fulfillment. I am unmarried and have no children. I declare I have no outstanding debts. Bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling and surrounding acres. My nephew, in the event that Terrence should precede me, then and in such event, the bequest to him shall fall to his children as ordered by age. Okay, so that's basically just what we read here, except in his messy handwriting. Okay. Dad, Benjamin Allman, The Killing of JFK, a theory. You've seen the movie, Discover the Truth. Sounds like it's garbage. I like Dad's books better. I don't like this corner. Alright. A bunch of coupons. We got tortilla chips. Oh man, I can go for some tortilla chips right now. Chips and salsa. Oh my god. State Department of Agriculture. Alright. I like this room. Now that there are lights on. Is this like another light? Oh, this is a bar. Oh, you got a bar? This house is the shit. Nice fat library, a bar with more bookcases in it. I wonder if Dad's got more porn magazines stashed around here. World history. Yeah. Open folder. Read assignment. Samantha Greenbrier. Reproductive system worksheet. It says testicles. The menstrual cycle of a fella. Wow. Sounds like someone didn't like this story. Oh, Samantha. Is this more music I'm going to get in trouble for?
Somehow I always knew that someday we'd be through. Now that it's happened.
That's not my cup of tea. Don't we have anything better? We have like Slayer? Yeah. Grab a bottle. Vodka, triple distilled. Nice. I just want to throw everything around. Are you in the way? Oops. I didn't even see I had it. Oh, there it is. Now open. Open. All right, we already read that book. What's this? Dear Mr. Greenbrier. Alright, this is from 76. I write to inform you that unfortunately Mercury Books will be unable to publish a follow-up to The Accidental Pariah. Despite the low sales of The Accidental Savior, we went ahead with publication of the second book in hopes of the John Russell series catching on. However, sales of the second book have in fact been lower than those of the first, and so our stewardship of the series must end here. It's been a pleasure working with you as your publisher. We wish you and John Russell the best in your future endeavors. Screw you, Donald. My dad's a great writer. Yeah. Irish whiskey. You're just sorts of... Looks like someone was hitting the booze pretty hard before I got here. Sam drinking it up. Dude, how many records do they have? That's got a shitload of extra books. Any more porn underneath? No? Doesn't look it. What's that say? Samantha, please give this to your mother. Thank you for having Danny over to your new home. He has missed having his friends, Smith, in the neighborhood very much. Danny asked if he could lend Samantha his Nintendo Street Fighting tape. Now you have permission. He needs to spend Samantha know that she is welcome back home.
When you live in one place your whole life, your next door neighbor is kind of like your default friend. And Daniel only got weirder over the years. So moving away has been a good excuse to, like, not see him anymore. But he did always have the good Nintendo games. Maybe I'll give him a call.
Those are the things that matter. The good Nintendo games. Alright. Okay, it's just the door. Read note. Katie, please tell Mom and Dad sorry about the stuff that's missing. Sam. Why do I gotta tell them? What did you do? Mm-hmm. And? I got a 4. Let's try this one. And, oh, 3. Lip balm. Oh, I'll make my lips nice and pretty. Oh, Jesus, stand back up. Alright, let's start opening drawers. Read note. Hi, Lonnie. So if you want to come over to my house still this afternoon, that would be cool. I can drive. It's kind of far, but I can drive you home too, so hopefully that's fine. Right back and leave this in my lock if you still want to. We can meet in the parking lot after 6, Samantha. Yeah, I'm totally in. See you there. Then I'm going to kick your butt. Get ready.
So you know what they say about the best laid plans of mice and men? Yeah, turns out it applies to Street Fighter 2. At least I worked up the courage to walk into the 7-Eleven and ask for a turn, but... all that practice at home did not exactly translate in the wild. So after I was finished getting my butt kicked, I followed them outside while they smoked. And that was when she asked me if I was that psycho house girl. But then she said she's always really wanted to see the psycho house. Her name is Lonnie. She's coming over tomorrow.
Well, she sounds pretty cool. Ooh, nothing good there. And nothing good there. Katie, please, whatever you found, don't tell Mom and Dad. The attic. Sam, what is going on? It's locked. Whoops. the basement. Alright, so we've checked everything. Oh, that was a music room, not a bar. Dad's office, library, TV room. Okay. Well, let's go check the other side of the house. Our big-ass creepy house. Which I keep waiting for something to jump out and scare me. Asshole. Well, I guess we're not going there either. Well. Oh, I guess we're going up here. Newspaper clipping. Controlled burn for Boone County. Smoke rise over the northeastern Boone County over the better part of next week. Forest crews have been preparing there for months. A burn operation will take place between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. Senior comes. Oh! Mom's involved. That's pretty cool. Deck of cards? Sorry, guys. I just need some way to amuse myself. Exam form. Temporary personnel transfer. Bruce Pendleton. Let's see, to aid in the upcoming prescribed burn operation. Oh. Personal calendar. Cooking class, ballroom dancing. Wow. Looks like they're leading a full life. Up cassette case. Bratmobile? My god, that's an incredible name for a band. What did it say? For Sam? Oh yeah, right there, for Sam.
It's weird hanging out with girls. Daniel was around ever since I was little, and other girls? I don't know. But being around Lonnie is like instantly just right. I gave her the grand Psycho House tour and took my revenge on Super Nintendo. And it was like, I don't know, I finally found someone I feel normal around. I drove her home and she gave me this tape and said, "You have got to listen to this." I haven't stopped playing it since.
Aw, sis is making a friend. Anything cool? Well, alright, let's check out our drawers. No, turn on. Well, who taught you how to fold laundry? This is a disgrace. Ooh, what's this? Cool Schmool. Oh my god, that was bad. What's this? Oh, I love Adventure Cat Returns. Chun-Li moves. Someone's been practicing. Scrutinize. I don't see anything. It's actually hurt my eyes. What we got here? Super Spitfire. Classic. Journey of Crystal. Wasn't bad. I like the second one better. Before we go checking anything else out, what's this? Sam, I think to create a writing track would be perfect for you. Oh, full scholarship. What was that noise? What's this? Oliver Twist, Thompson. Well, she's got some good books there. Yep, that's what it looks like. Oh crap, there's a combination. What did he say? I haven't had that much to drink, Jody Foster. How many fingers? That's cool. Steggy. Salmon magazine. Oh yeah, that guy. All right. Oh wait, leave it open. That way I know I checked it out. It's here. Goodfellow High School disciplinary referral. Yolanda DeSoto. Let's see. Mr. Benchley observed Ms. DeSoto wearing a t-shirt with an unacceptable image on the front. Large beer can label. Okay, that's bad. Ms. DeSoto was sent to the guidance counselor's office. Let's see, Miss DeSoto was given the option to turn her shirt inside out, change into a shirt from her gym locker, or be suspended for the rest of the day. Miss DeSoto chose suspension. What a rebel. Her father was called, but there was no answer and no answering machine. Miss DeSoto must return this form tomorrow, signed by her father. Really? For wearing a PBR shirt? What a bunch of assholes. Is there anything down here I should be looking for? Samantha Greenbuyer, Yearling Fletcher, Metalworking Engraving Grade C. Found a challenging assignment, metal plaque for family portrait, reasonable subject, but not complete. When I said that mom and dad should be replaced with parents' names, I did not mean just add them underneath. Acceptable leveling on edges, show more pride. Oh, Sam. This is the one me and my dad are building. Wanna go for a ride when it's done? Yes. Alright. Dude, your closet is awesome. It's like an extra room. What we got? Got your number. No, you don't. Oh, we're still going with this Captain Allegra thing? It's a lot to read. And I don't think it has anything to do with the story, so we're not going to worry too much about it. Go back and read that on your own. But there's something there. What is this? A Bible? Alright. Wait, whatever boat you float, Sam. Aww. What the hell was that? Anyways, what's it say? 1888? Okay. There we go. Yes, 1888. Oh, wrong button. Let's get rid of it. Is this 1888? Not even close. Okay, so this just wraps around. So I'm not going to. Alright, so I didn't see any combination for that, which is really a bummer. I kind of want to know the combination. Alright, you know what, guys? I'm gonna cheat a little bit. You're gonna give me a second. I'm gonna look up and see what her combination was. Let's bring up the old Google. Let's see. Locker. Combination. Gone home. Locker is, alright, it's 0501. I know, I'm cheating. But I don't know if I'll come across, and I really want to know what's in here. I really am that nosy. Hot damn, what are you hiding? Ooh. Sam liked the ladies? Nothing wrong with that. Sam smoking? Oh, there's Lonnie. There's the basement key.
Lonnie came over today. But everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no. There was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie, do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me.
Okay. So it seems like Lonnie and Sis are a little bit more than just friends. Cool with that. Jesus Christ, Sam really did ransack this place. Are those condoms? Ew, I agree. Holy jeans. We didn't need to see the condoms. Aw, mitten. Ew. Ooh, what do they got for movies? Butch Cassidy, The Sundance Kid, The Fugitive, All the President's Men, Bridge on the River Kwai, Silence of the Lambs, can't read the other ones. Oh, Sound of Music. I don't get the other one. I can't really read it. Ooh, I got a nice bathroom. Alright, well, before you do the bathroom, let's check out this closet. Watercolor techniques. Like someone's trying to be an artist. What's the letter say? Dear Jan, understand how you feel. Bob and I have had our own periods. It's become a bit of a way of life, actually. You get used to each other, you live your own lives in the same house. The kids grow up, they go away. Sorry, this is opening, is it? Don't worry. Terry will get over whatever's distracting him. Things go back to normal. As for Sam being distant, that's a teenager for you. Nothing to worry about. In the meantime, though, it's controlled burn. That sounds like quite the adventure. Let's cut to the chase. This new ranger they sent, that's what I want to hear about. Ranger Rick, are you kidding me? You have to tell me anything. Keep your chin up until Terry is out of his slump, blah blah blah. Also, things aren't going well for Mom and Dad. Sam and Bookmark. What's that say? Take your time. I'm glad to have it in good hands. Mom, are you hooking up with a Ranger Rick? Walt Whitman, huh? Mom, you scumbag. Let's check out Mom's purse. Nothing over here on Dad's side? No. Well, he's got a Bible too. Was that for me? Yep. Dear Mom, Dad, and Sam, I am in the tunnel. This is my second passage through the tunnel on my way back from London. This time going to Brussels. Belgium. Sorry I didn't write you on the way to London, but I was too excited. Alright, say tunnel one more time. London was great. Dad, I know you always wanted to visit, and I think you should. You'll love it. If you all want to come back here someday, oh, sometime I guess I could be convinced. Love you all. Yeah. That's what I thought. Ooh. Were Mom and Dad stoners? That's like perfect stoner music. Alright, let's ransack the bathroom. So their bathroom has its own bathroom. Which is nuts. After the honeymoon, rediscovering your spouse personally, spiritually. Ew. So I guess there's nothing good here in Mom and Dad's room. That's Sam's room where we came out of. What's this? Reading this note. Well, that's not really anything interesting now, is it? Alright. What's this thing right here? Another bathroom. Oh, it's hair dye. I thought that was blood. I was gonna get worried. Nailed it. Red right hand.
Oh. Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. That's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked in the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy or good or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited. And the moment was gone.
Aww. This is kind of cool. I'm liking the whole backstory we're getting about the sister and this girl, Lonnie. There we go. I missed that poster. I bet Sam's the one who's obsessed with the X-Files. Well, that looks inviting. What's this? Katie, Mom and Dad were going to make up the guest room for you to stay in over the summer. You came home on such short notice that they weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. I won't be needing it anymore, Sam. Aww. This is my room? It's kind of a bitchin' room. Book. Miscellaneous. Hey Sam, you were asking what my something ribbons mean. Oh, our junior ROTC. Orienteering means the Army thinks I can find my way around. Rifle team. Army has branded me as a certified killing machine. Adventure training. I'm a burn adventures and no borders can hold me. The Army recognizes this. So if you didn't think I was cool before, now you do, Lonnie. Okay, so Lonnie's in the junior ROTC. What's this? Tall shadow in the upstairs hall when I rounded the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? No, I was not wearing my glasses. Okay. Faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello, did not investigate, probably was the furnace. Poured milk from carton and fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I ran spoons and sour milk. Milk was not just yesterday. Mommy says she feels a presence in the TV room. Suddenly begin to feel cold. We build a protective pillow for it. Good call. Lonnie and I employ Ouija board as a medium. Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remain unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in the attic. probably leaky roof. Sample taken just in case. Due to our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. So wait, is this place legitimately haunted? Like, am I right in worrying that something's gonna jump out and scare the crap out of me? Even now I don't want to open the door. Okay. Jesus Christ, Katie, how much stuff do you have? That's someone's art room. Jesus. That thunder scared me. What's this? Supervising a square. Oh, is this Ranger Rick? Has been indispensable during the course of the prescribed burn procedure. Rick's assignment to this facility. Whoa, is Mom trying to hook up with Ranger Rick? That's not cool. Halloween show. Misfits. They're awesome. See you there.
Sometimes you just have to lie to Mom and Dad.
Mm-hmm.
Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to Mom and Dad's situation. But it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. And everybody was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?" I was so happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
Aw. All right. No. Oh. I mean, I like some crazy weird music, but what the hell is that? Any more Dad's books? What's this? Saved her from the region. Oh! Is that, Mom fantasizing about Ranger Rick? Oh, cool. I don't like where this Mom and Ranger Rick is. Healthy choices for a healthy life. Alright. Lonnie, holy crap. I was in the library and noticed something in the corner from the secret passage, and it had Oscar's creepy old stuff in it. Got to see this. We're skipping six. So, Mom and Dad's room. Alright, so this goes on the map? It does. Alright. Definitely want to check that out. Captain Allegra, the first mate. That's pretty cool. So this is the sitting room, apparently. This is our sewing room. crazy would it be to have a house that had like a room for every activity you could possibly do? Seems darker. Do not enter if red lights are on. Alright, we're going to mom and dad's room. And it was in their closet? Is that when I saw this? Now I'm scared. What's going on? Why? Paintings all around? So loved the world that he gave his only son. Whoops. Yeah, put that shit back. Let's see. Hidden compartments, found 3. Library, upstairs, hall, foyer. Evidence of supernaturals discovered. We're in a library now, right? Oh, so I gotta get to the basement. Misfits, Maiden Heads, Stygia, Saturday, October 29.
At Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon to sleep on, so Lonnie and I shared it. The lights went out. I was turned toward her, my eyes started to adjust, and then I could see she was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so, I don't know, nervous? After a minute, she put her arm around me and was so close and whispered in my ear, "I really like you." I just nodded my head and I really hope she could tell. I really hope that she meant what I think she did. I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since. I hope we have the chance to talk before I explode.
Aww. I mean, we already know what happens, but still, it's pretty nice, you know, seeing the progression. Alright, so we already did Dad's office. Apparently... something over here? Is this what I was seeing? of douches around here. Let's look at the map again. That's enough. Do not read. Heaven at the Edge of the World, the Green Glacier Part 2. Alright, more of this Captain Allegra stuff. Okay. Oh yeah, I have a backpack. Oh, those are all the audios. Alright. Where was I going? Oh, I was going to the basement. Am I? I checked everything out. I checked that out. To go in the probably super scary basement. Which I'm not too happy about. Oh, this basement looks kind of cool. Go make me a sandwich. I'll be your best friend. No? Assholes. Aw, Sam and Lonnie.
It's different now. I mean, we still hang out all the time like before. But now when no one else is around. Well, you know. So you could say we're dating. But it's secret. Secret dating? I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the real difference. Now when we get off the phone, or go home for the night, or it's just quiet and we're alone, we say I love you.
Uh-huh. Shouldn't have to secret date, though. Should never be ashamed of who you're dating. I mean, not that they sound ashamed, it just sounds like they're trying to hide it because people won't understand. That's not cool. Oh, Caitlin. K is for kind, A is for amazing, I intelligent, T talented, L lighthearted, I important, and nice. Oh, that's me in a nutshell. One of Dad's old sex ed assignments. Oh, that's not nearly as entertaining as Sam's was. Oh, that was a thing I was hearing making noise. Scared the crap out of me. Good. You people have. Okay, looks good. I really am convinced something's going to jump out and scare the crap out of me. Recollege, J. or Samantha, congratulations. We inform you that your mission to create a writing track. Lessons, we believe you have much to contribute. Oh, so she got it.
I'm so stupid sometimes. I was telling Lonnie that I got into my college summer program thing, and I was all making plans like, you should come visit me, stay in my dorm room. But she said, Sam, I ship out on June 6th. I was like, ship out? To where? She said, to basic training. What did you think I was doing all that ROTC stuff for? I guess she's been planning to join the Army right after high school since she was like 12. And I guess she's really going to do it. So I was like, after graduation, I'm just never going to see you again? She said, let's just have fun while we can.
That sucks. I was really rooting for those two kids. Joyce is really understanding. Okay. Alright, I want to talk about this. What the fuck? Professor Laureate of English, University of Oregon, 1950s. Yeah, why is his face cut out? Alright, that's what I want to address. One, I want to address the fact that it sucks that those two girls have that problem. Two, why is his face gone? I'm really rooting for the two of them. I hope things work out for them. Something stuck. What's it say? Thank you for sending a copy of your newly published book. Author's first published manuscript, the most case I read. Certainly recognize my son in the subject matter. An author's work is in the experimentation of that which he holds dear. Oh, so this is from Granddad. The lens through which the personal alone was, and this is how the genre cliches and implausible. Conventionally surviving the great ordeal. You can do better. Wow. Thanks a lot, Granddad. Asshole. Pharmacy soda fountain. Ooh, soda fountain. That's pretty cool. Oh, is mom not an American citizen? Where's she from, does it say? I can't read all that crap. Oh, she's from Canada. I thought she was from somewhere cool. LOL, Canada's cool, don't hate. Was there a bedroom in the basement? What is going on? X-ray specs, I wonder if that's one of their bands. Dear Sam, I'm so happy you like to draw. Your writing is awful. You'd love Mexico, I think, probably. But you're so different back home. I'm lying in bed and I can almost feel you. I've been trying to save it up for you. I haven't done a good job, okay, but I tried. Okay, enough about that. Your last letter got to me the day before we started driving back north. We'll be racing this letter home. If I get home first, we can read it together. And yes, I'm taking tons of photos, blah, blah, blah. Alright, can't do those. Is that something right there I can grab? It says, it's like a drug. The first time was in my room in the middle of the night. I woke up and Lon was kissing me. Why? Is it a sex thing? I didn't get to read the whole thing. Alright, who do we got here? Girl Scouts. Okay, this one's not bad. Oops. Alright, Girl Scout was bad. What's this? Girl Scout, the band formerly known as Cub Scout, sent this role model. Okay.
Todd's band lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit. And he was complaining about needing a new singer. So Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now. And I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. And she's actually really amazing. I feel so proud when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love. So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Well, that's cool. Alright, so are these like servants' quarters? They are servants' quarters. So there's, yes, so I haven't been to the dining room, the greenhouse, laundry room, washroom, pantry, or the kitchen. And you're safe. That doesn't work. What's this? Let's get somewhere where I can read. Dude, I can't even read that. Grab toy. Is there anything on the toy? Oh, Terry. Oh, okay. Nope, nothing. If you play this wearing headphones, that thunder and lightning is really crazy. Alright, is there anything down here that would give me a combination of that safe? Grab book. Masson's Pharmacy, 1968. Looks like someone's hoarding newspapers down here. Hey Sam, I'm writing for you in Winter Falls. I'm here on a stupid class trip, which is stupid because it's March, and I don't know if anyone in the school has been to. It's cold and rainy as shit in March. But you're here. Oh, wait, you are here because I'm writing this to you in the gift shop. Oh, shit.
They tell you to stick with the group on field trips, Katie. There's a reason for that. Lonnie and I snuck off on the side paths at Multnomah Falls and got a little lost. Okay, a lot lost. Like, for hours. Right before the bus left, we found a trail and came running down the path, soaked and covered in mud, shouting for the bus not to leave. The school called home. Mom and Dad said, "You didn't get into trouble like this before you met that Lonnie girl." But I don't think they know about us. kids at school, though? I'm really afraid that's a whole other story. Stick with the group, Katie. Stick with the group.
No, that's horrible advice. Be yourself. Who the hell cares what all these other people think? You do you and be happy. Right, that exit's out somewhere. Oh, hey, they got their own little setup here? Okay, so there's a few places. Girl justice. Still no pizza. I like this. This is cool. They found the hidden ways. They got their own little setup here. I want a setup like this. Dear Miss Greenbrier, I appreciate your time and effort to put into writing your letter. You chose initiative, and it's well written, but it's not changed my mind on this matter. I understand that Mrs. Soto is a friend of yours. Did you guys hear that? The fact of the matter is that she defaced school property with profanity. The fact that she alleged to deface her own locker in retaliation for doing the same to yours is immaterial.
I don't get Lonnie sometimes. Like, her band, and our zine, and her hair, and everything are all anti-authority. But I watch her in JROTC, and she's doing drills in perfect formation, following orders, no question. And there's all this stuff in the news about don't ask, don't tell. Like, she's going to join the army and then have to lie? About who she is? She said they don't need to know what they don't need to know. Like it was no big deal. This from the girl who trashed her locker to, like, defend my honor. I've learned when to stop arguing, though. I don't think Lonnie even gets Lonnie sometimes.
Yeah, she's a contradiction. Well, that's a lie to mom and dad situation, but it's so worth it, the girl. Okay. Cool stuff about being the psycho house girl. The cool thing one, everybody in the hall. What are they looking at? Okay. Okay. Women outlaws. I can dig it. Okay. So they're doing stuff. Oh, there's a light switch right there. No tape. Alright, what's over here? Have I not been here? Where am I? Oh, I'm on the other side where the door was locked. Okay, well before I do that, what's this way? No way. There's one in my room? It's creepy as balls. That freaks me out. What's this? 196.3. Oh, I wonder if that's for the safe combination? Yeah, these sounds the house is making is really freaking me out. Wait, did it record that? Crap, 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 I forgot it already. Was that 196.3? I need to stop running my mouth. No. Who are we joking? I can't stop running my mouth. I need to do better at remembering this. Alright. Okay. 196.3. You guys got that? 196.3. Yo, Katie, would it kill you to move a little faster? Sister, I don't know what any of that says. What is this? Hydrogen peroxide, oil of clove. A quaddle. Syringe. Someone doing drugs? Billeron. Another syringe. Morphine. Morphine. I think someone's doing the drugs. Okay, I thought there'd be something cool in there, but all I got are syringes, a rubber tube, and some drugs. Unlocked now. What's this? Shampoo set. Jesus, Mom. Trying to look all like spiffy from good old Ranger Rick. Order of promotion. Due to your exemplary management of the footlock, burn operation last year and the services need for personnel, to offer you the position of regional conversation management director. Your assistance would be sought to fill the previous blah 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 blah. Cool. Mom got a promotion. Yeah, Spanish. I can barely speak English. Ooh, what do we got here? Hey, Lonnie. Sorry my mom was such a bitch last night. She's hardly ever around since her forest is like an hour away. And then when she is home, she takes it out on you, like, because you're not a member of the family, she knows you won't call her on it, and I'm sorry. It's okay. I know she's just jealous of our cool and freewheeling lifestyles. I feel sorry for you. I'm lucky my mom lives in Florida. You have to have a mom every day. Sorry, I don't mean to bring up the mom thing like that. I know I shouldn't complain. No, I'm being serious. My mom is a psycho Christian, and her new husband, Don, is a complete tool. Living in Florida with him is her eternal punishment in my mind. So you wouldn't rather live with your mom in Florida? I'm going to take that as a no. What's this? Earth, wind, fire. Mom and Dad going to a show? Sam. This skull was the coolest thing I found in Mexico, and it was like $3 American. I love it. Merry Christmas, Miss UPS. Treasure always. Okay, so that's the one we saw on the bookcase out in the foyer. Dining room. Mom's purse. No, nothing. What's this? Hi, Jan. I got 2 tickets for the Earth, Wind, Fire on Thursday, but my girlfriend says she doesn't want to go. Her taste in music is its ugly head again. So it leaves me with an extra ticket that I thought you might be interested in. Ooh. Back off, Rick. What's Dad up to anyways? I mean, we see all this stuff that's going on with Sam. You see Mom and Ranger Rick. You just know Dad's having a hard time with his writing. Saw that. Sam, since you refused to hear yourself this afternoon, your mother and I are putting this in writing so that we are absolutely clear. You are grounded for the rest of the month from social telephone privileges and from using your car for anything except going to and from school. We understand what you are going through, but we can't allow you to continue this kind of behavior at school. And clearly, once your privileges are reinstated, we can't allow you to have your bedroom door closed while Lonnie's at this house. This is the last word on the matter. Get back on course so this won't happen again. Display referral. Distributing inappropriate materials on school grounds. Phone call the student's parents out of school suspension for 4 days.
I had an interesting talk with Mom and Dad tonight.
Ooh.
One you were never gonna need to have. I mean, you've known, right? I've known. I've known since, like, She-Ra. Mom and Dad didn't, I guess. They saw the zine and the stuff on the locker, and they were like, is there something we should know about you and Lonnie? And so here's the thing. I was prepared for them to be mad or disappointed or start crying or something, but they were just in denial. You're too young to know what you want. You and Lonnie are just good friends. You just haven't met the right boy. It's a phase. That's what I didn't see coming. That they wouldn't even respect me enough to believe me. Well, joke's on them, because they're in for one very long phase.
Yeah, that's just bullshit. Shouldn't treat your kids like that because of who they like. No butts in heaven. Excuse me, yawning. Hi, Mom, Dad, and Sam. The Vatican is weird. As you can see, the Catholic Church still has a lot of money left over from the Middle Ages. I'm going to see all the art, including the Sistine Chapel ceiling and the sculptures by Michelangelo, Donatello, and the rest of the Ninja Turtles. Alright, Katie's pretty cool. Mom, we have to come back together. I would love to be here with someone who really appreciates the history behind everything. Also, Sam, they have various relics, as in pieces of important dead people, so you should come too. Next stop, Barcelona. Calm down, Dad. I won't get gored by a bull. Probably. Love, Katie. Yeah, so anyways, what I was saying, this whole it's only a phase thing, you haven't met the right boy, it's a load of crap. The reason why she hasn't met the right boy is because she doesn't like boys. Assholes. Don't give up on this, honey. Accidental warrior. Well, is Mom actually being supportive? Not running around going all Ranger wreck. Just making sure I didn't miss anything. So I came out here. And this is the kitchen. What sort of crappy music do we have here? Guess that was okay. What we got here? Savior. That's a different looking cover. Press water dispenser. Freezer. What we got? I'm super hungry now. Someone make me food. See, Sam's schedule. Working at Crown Burger on Bethel Road. Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. 7. Unless I think it was 7. Alright, Stirrings. The Blair request your presence at the mayor's daughter. Right now I'm just picking up everything just to see if we get more story. Because for me that's what's important right now. I'm gonna find out more what's going on with Sam and Lonnie. Those two kids gonna make it? Seriously, no one saved me any pizza at all. Samantha and Daniel were in the woods one day. It was sunny and blah, blah, blah.
Did Daniel finally came over to get his game. I'd been dreading it. But he brought this story with him that I wrote when we were little. I started reading it. And then there I was, crying at the kitchen table. He asked what was wrong, and I was thinking about how we used to be friends, how much I'd taken for granted. But instead, I told him about school, and Dad, and Lonnie. And then how sorry I was that I wasn't his friend anymore. He gave me a hug and said it was going to be okay. For some reason, I almost believed him.
Yeah, so he's not a bad person after all. Well, I mean, not bad, but annoying. Alright. Any good snacks? Guess not. That's a bummer. What's this? Accidental pariah. Dear Mr. Greenbrier, first let me say I hope this missive finds you well. Hell, it feels like a goddamn miracle that finds you at all. Do you know how long we've been trying to track you down? Worry not, we aren't the feds, the men in black, or any other sort of creepy fascist hobgoblins. In fact, we're on your side. Let me start from the beginning. Alright. Unknown Dimensions is one of our hollow specialist publishers. We trapped in the weird this time. The lost but not forgotten, a small but dedicated group of plugged-in bibliophile types of out-there mass marketing shunning visionary expression. Oh my god, guy. We've had an unparalleled run since our inception 4 years ago, unearthing and reviving Christ or zombie-like timeless works such as N.N. Bestman's Message of the Snake Man, It's Inside Me by Jens Keller, blah, blah, blah. But ever since we discovered tattered copies of your accidental series at a church rummage sale in Long Beach, New Jersey, we've been trying to track down the author of this weird and dark American outsider art that's just a kind of forgotten portal into the 20th century civilization anxiety, blah, 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 blah. A John Russell, mild-mannered insurance agent by day, reckless history-revising sociopath by night, is the twisted peacekeeper that it deserves, and the mission... Okay, so I've typed plenty. What do we want from you? We want your permission to reprint the book. Nice. Since your original publisher, Mercury Books, folded a decade ago, we want you to supply a new foreword for the book, to appear in brand new editions of the Accidental Savior and the Accidental Pariah, to be produced by Unknown Dimensions as a limited run and marketed directly to our highly discerning out customer base. And we want to offer a portion of the proceeds. We look forward to embarking with you into the nice. So Dad's books are getting reprinted. Well, that's awesome. Samuel will be away for a long weekend celebrating anniversary. We will be camping in the gorge, but we will give you a call on the way home. Sorry the kitchen is still mid-renovation. Never trust a contractor. $40 is on the table to order pizza while we're gone. Be good. All right, well, left me $40. Anyone I know on this? No? Lonnie, my parents are leaving town, so we'll have the run of the whole house to leave. I imagine actually spending the night in my room instead of sneaking up to our usual spot in the attic. Not that the attic doesn't have its musty allure, but my bedroom is warmer. Sam, we should defile your parents' bed while they're gone. That'll show them. Lonnie, your gross never change. Ah, you two crazy kids. So where's next? What is this? Booted out. Going away show for Lonnie.
Lonnie had her going away show with her band tonight. She's so incredible on stage. When she was singing, I could practically forget everything. That we only had 48 hours left. That I don't know what comes next. That I can't live without her. Then she dedicated the last song to me. And I couldn't take it. I was out on the curb in the alley, sobbing till my ribs hurt. I would follow her anywhere, Katie. But I can't. Where she's going. After a long time, she found me. She said she was sorry. She said, I wish things could be different. I just wanted to make you happy. I said, I don't think you can anymore.
Aww. No, I'm cheering for you guys. Oh, it's too dark to read there. Right, we need somewhere with light. Hi, Mom, Dad, and Sam. I have had a wonderful time on the beaches of Barcelona. Dad and Sam, I think you would like the gaudy architecture. It is from a strange alien world. I am headed to my final destination, Amsterdam. For how long? That depends on how stoned I get. I am running low on money. I will look for a cheap standby ticket and call you when I'm heading home. Sorry for the short notice. Can't wait to see you all again. It'll be good to be home. Love, Katie. Alright, laundry room. Anything I can get my hands on? I wish I knew how to explain it better. The army is this thing I grew up with. It's part of me. My dad's army friends are like family. I've always known it was where I'd end up. I'd never thought of it any other way. I wish things could be different. Maybe someday when I'm settled at a base and you're done with college and you're a famous writer and I can rebuild a tank engine with my eyes closed, things will be different and we can be together until then. This is killing me. I really want to know what's going on with them. Mrs. Will will do it. Oh, I already found that place. Midnight, June 5th, final preparations.
We agreed our last night together would be our happiest ever. And we'd forget tomorrow was going to come at all. It worked for a while. We had a good time seeing Oscar off, then ran up to the attic to look through our photos, to find one for Lonnie to take with her. And looking at them, I realized they were all in the past, and there wouldn't be any more. And I didn't know what I was going to do. And I cried. And she held me. She said she knew it was hard, but life would move on. I said I didn't want my life to keep moving without her. That's when she cried too. I was so exhausted. I must have fallen asleep like that, in her arms. In the morning, I woke up, and I was finally alone.
Oh man, don't tell me she left. Right, it's been almost 20 years since John Russell heard the call. Twice he saved the president's life. He's practically forgotten the days from the future. So when the familiar rip in time opens in front of him and his handler peers out, he doesn't hesitate. Is the president in danger? No, the life you save this time will be your own. Was Dad writing a new book? Alright, dear Kaz. Can't tell you what a joy it is to see John Russell back in print. Thank you very much for seeing... Oh, for sending along copies of the new editions. The cover art is really something. I know you said that Unknown Dimension is in the business of printing new material, but this revived interest in my book has brought on a wave of inspiration, resulting in a manuscript that completes John Russell's journey, which I think you may find intriguing. It is reflective and introspective, without forgetting the excitement and the weirdness that Unknown Dimensions readers expect. I hope this might be an exciting new direction for Unknown Dimensions to pursue. At the very least, I'm grateful that John Russell's adventures didn't come to an end quite when I thought they had. My thanks and regards, Terrence L. Greenbrier. Oh, you go, Dad. The accidental human. So if I couples counseling retreat. Okay, looks like Dad's trying to, like, you know, keep the family together. And then Mom's just out whoring around. Oh, that's why they look different, because they're the new book covers. Alright. So if I literally looked at everything? I don't see where everything else could be. I think I have to go to the attic now. How do I get into the attic? It was locked before, if I remember correctly. Did I miss something? I had to have missed something. Alright, you guys just give me a minute. We're going to find out how to get the attic. Because I've honestly missed something, apparently. Where is the attic key? Where's Sam's room? It's right here. Is there a key in here? Alright, so that's our Lonnie. This is kind of killing me. Like, it should be around here somewhere. I missed something? There's supposed to be something over here. Okay. Possessions and exorcism. Weird. Got it.
The sunset light in this house is the saddest thing I've ever seen. I just want to sleep. When I'm in the attic, it almost feels like Lonnie could still be here. She's just downstairs. I'm just waiting to hear her pull down the hatch and come running up. Maybe I'll go up to the attic and wait.
All right. So it looks like we're up to some demonic exorcism going on here. Oh, that must be Uncle Who's a... Well, what's it? Oh. Yep, that's chalk. Okay, so they were trying to communicate with this ghost. You know, I think that would have been a really cool thing. Just like maybe out of the corner of your eye or something, you would have seen like his ghost or someone walk off. Because at the beginning, this game gave off a creepy vibe. And, I honestly thought there were going to be like jump scares or something weird going on, but it turns out it's just walking around. Ooh, that's a nice little corner. Sam, I'll always remember what we had. Stay strong, kick ass. I love you, Lonnie.
Oh my god. Katie, I fell asleep in the attic, in Lonnie in my old spot, and I missed the first two calls. I just barely caught the third one before the machine got it. And it was Lonnie, on a payphone. She'd been on the bus to Basic, and she said she couldn't think of anything but me and us, and that she couldn't go through with it, with the army and being a part and all of it. And so she got off the bus in Salem. She said, Sam, I want you to pack up everything you can and get in your car and come find me. And let's just drive until we find somewhere for us. And she asked me if I could do that. And I said yes. Yes.
Aww. So they are just getting together. It's awesome. I like that picture. Do we get anything more? Like, what's going on? Letters to Katie.
Katie, I'm so sorry that I can't be there to see you in person. That I can't tell you all this myself. But I hope as you read this journal and you think back, that you'll understand why I had to do what I did. And that you won't be sad, and you won't hate me. And you'll just know that I am where I need to be. I love you so much, Katie. I'll see you again. Someday. Love, Sam.
Okay, cool. So, can we get out of here? Oh, we can get out of here. Okay, so that's Gone Home. I thought there would be a little bit more to it. Like, it was all creepy and stuff, and you hear about the things about it possibly being haunted and the fact that it's the Psycho House. I thought we'd get, like, some, you know, at least at the very least, we get some jump scares. Maybe see something weird, like walking by a window or something. But instead, you know, we got a pretty cool story. You know, this family's going through its problems. Dad's, you know, a failed writer who gets a second chance. Mom's unhappy in her marriage and is hanging out with Ranger Rick. Then we got young sister Sam who gets a girlfriend and parents don't quite know how to handle it. No, this was a really good game. I enjoyed the story. Like I said, I thought it would just be, you know, a little bit more scary than it really was, but it's really nothing to complain about. I think I picked this up on the cheap. So if you ever see it on the cheap and you want to grab it, I would say go for it. Ooh, excuse me, burp. But, yeah, that's going to do it for this game, Gone Home. I think, not sure what my next game is going to be, but I'll probably be getting it up within the next couple of days. So until then, take care of yourself, stay hydrated, very important, and I will see you all next time. Later.